Hello Summoners, welcome back to the channel, and in this video we're going to talk about Angela because she is getting a buff next month and even now she's a pretty decent character. So in this video we're going to play around with her in Act 6, and this is pre-buffed gameplay. You might get confused because she hits really hard, and this is a 565 Angela with Suicide Masteries. She doesn't even need to be awakened. So I haven't played with her in a long time, but from what I remember, the best rotation is to almost get to 2 bars of power and then use a special 1. And that way, like, the special attack themselves, they don't do any damage, like they do negligible damage, but as soon as you cross a bar of power, you gain a fury, and that is a pretty big heavy attack. And you're going to see her finish this fight with a massive 15,000 medium attack. This is a 565 character unboosted. Like, 15,000 medium attack is really impressive. And remember when she came out, a lot of people said that she should have Bleeze because she has a sword and everything, but from what I remember, Kavam replied that that would just make her damage pretty OP, and maybe that was true for that time. But now that we have characters like Cosmic Ghost Rider, I'm guessing she will have a bleed, because it is a value only buff. And she already has some great damage output from the basic hits, so I'm not sure, but I am really excited to see what they do with her, because I'm not sure if I said this before, but she is definitely the best character ever to get a buff. And that's kind of crazy. Like, Angela is, I'm not sure where I've placed her in my tier list, but I'd say she's definitely above average. Like, for a new player, like, if I start a new account, I pull 5-star Angela, I'd be really happy, and I'm sure she would help a lot in even endgame content. Like, she is really good for nose like buffed up, which are really common. Like, until this month, we were seeing buffed up in every single Cavalier difficulty, and especially like in the Cosmic chapter, we also had the aptitude buffs, which just made her crazy. Like, I know that for the 4-star challenge, a lot of people were using a 4-star Angela to get that down, and on top of that, she does have like armor ups, pretty reliable ones, so she is a havoc counter. She has regeneration, pretty suicide friendly, even though she is not immune to any of the debuffs. She doesn't have any immunities at all. But I am very surprised to see that she is getting a buff. Now, I want to acknowledge something very important here, because a lot of people are going to say that she is a Cosmic character, and Cosmic class has a lot of duds like Airwalker, Groot, Venom Pool, Superior Iron Man. And the fact that she is getting a buff over them. Now, there is a very important thing to note here. This is a value only buff, and those four characters, and I'm sure there are more, they need much more than just small updates to the kits. And even then, I am still surprised that Angela even qualifies for a buff, because in my books, she is a pretty decent character and she didn't need it. But at the same time, I'll gladly take it, because I'm sure a lot of people, I don't have her as a 6-star, but I'm sure a lot of people do. I think I actually saw a rank 3 6-star Angela earlier today on Twitter, like a screenshot, which is pretty crazy, but I get it. Like, I'm sure there are a lot of people with 565 Angelas, because she was and still is a very usable character, as you probably would have known. This is not a great fight, because of the like node, how he was becoming passive there with the in the armor phrase. I'm forgetting the name of the node, but yeah, you can see, like, even with two furies, we did over 10,000 mediums, and all of her damage does come from her basic attacks. Ignore these special attacks. I hope her special attacks also get a change, like they do more damage, because, like, I remember sometimes, because I personally really like finishing fights with special attacks, it's kind of a habit. And if, like, you are, let's say this fight, right, 26,000 Act 6 Vulture, if I push him to 5% and launch a special, chances are he's not going to die, but instead, if I do 2 mediums, he'll probably will. So yeah, do keep that in mind while using her. But 48 hits, not the best fight, but still pretty impressive. So she doesn't have too much utility, and I would like to see something there. Her awakened ability is actually one of the most useless awakened abilities in the game. Not sure if they can even change that in a value only update, but basically, so far I've seen just one use for her awakened ability. It's kind of know, it used to be a meme, but it gives you a chance of the opponents nullify against you to fail, and the only use that has was a fight in 6.1 exploration. I think it was a Symbiote Supreme on buffed up, and that also had some other nodes which made it really annoying. So Thing and Angela, Awakened Angela, were probably the best counters there. But now let's take her against Realm of Legends Winter Soldier. Of course, how can you do a video without taking opponent up against this guy? And because his special attacks don't do that much damage, like after you gain one bar of power and you get into the rotation that I mentioned earlier, like constantly using SP1s, your basic attacks will just hit really, really hard. But because the special attacks don't, it will take a while to get this guy down. It won't take too long, but again, for a character who is hitting like 6000 light attacks and 10000 mediums, you would probably expect a lesser hit count at the end. But like honestly, characters like Angela, I kind of expect them to get synergies, like some good synergies that would make them very relevant again. But the fact that she is actually getting a buff gets me really excited about the future, because truth be told, like right now, whenever I pull a medium level, average, above average type character like Angela, I'm not really happy because I have a very developed roster. I don't really need characters like them. And instead, if I pull a bad character like Miles Morales or Iron Patriot, that is like, I'm more hopeful because I know that at some point they will get a buff. So the fact that Angela is getting a buff is pretty exciting, because now you never know in future what will happen. Like even medium tier characters with some tune-ups could become top tier characters again. So that would be pretty exciting. But that is going to do it for this one. Let me know what are your thoughts on the Angela buffs, and who do you think will be the other two characters getting. I think two characters are supposed to get a full overhaul next month, right? So do let me know, who do you think are going to be those two characters? But that is going to do it for this one. Thanks for watching. Have a nice day. Subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. Like this video. Let's aim to hit 100 likes. And share with your alliance. Stay safe. Bye-bye. Have a good one.